Hi guys, in this video we are going to discuss about performing like storing the objects into our S3 bucket, and also to read the objects from S3 bucket, and also we will perform versioning on the S3 bucket. So first of all, what is an S3? S3 is a simple storage service which is a storage service provided by AWS, Amazon Web Services. So here files are called as objects. So and the folder that consists of various things, that folder is called as a bucket, we can say. So first, initially, to perform all these things, we are performing it through Python. So we have to install SDK library called Boto3, and also we have to install S3FS. So the command that we use is pip3 install Boto3 and the pip3 install S3FS. So after that installation, we have to log in to the user account. So mine is a user account, so I logged in with the user account, and for that user account we have to generate a secret key so that only we can access our AWS. So for that we have to, in the security and credentials, if you go to the security and credentials, then you can find an access key where you have to click on it so as to create the access key. It will be a CSV file that is stored, and with that we can perform the operations. So first, initially, we will go to S3 service, and in our S3 service, see, there are no buckets, it is an empty one. So this is my Python code. So first initially you need to import Boto3 pandas os and .env file, which in the .env file we will give the our access key and the secret key that we downloaded, that we store in that .env, and with that we will access the S3. So for that, initially for the Boto3.client, we have to give the service which we are accessing. So here we are giving S3 that we want to access the service. So after that we have to mention the resources. So what is the service name, that is S3, and the region name. So region name, I am taking it as AP South 1. It's an Mumbai version. So here you can see all the various areas or regions on which you want to use it. So Mumbai is a AP South 1. So here in this region your bucket will be created. So that way, and then you have to access it using get env and the access key and the secret access key, that it will be stored. And now we want to create S3 bucket. So first, initially, let's run it, and the bucket should be a unique one. So S3 bucket should be a unique one, so name should be a unique one. Let's see, first we will run it. So it is running, and then we will create this also so that our get accessed. Let's see whether this bucket creates. Here we have to give the bucket name, also the location where you want to do it. So if the bucket is created, fine, otherwise we have to change the name. So yeah, fine, the bucket is created. Let's see here. See, bucket is created and it is public. So objects is also can be public. So first, initially, we will delete all these files so that we will get a clear understanding. Okay, so this is an env file which consists of access key and the secret key, and now we generated the bucket as well. So first, initially, now we'll press like what are the, for we will print out what are the buckets present. So we have only one bucket, so we got printed that bucket. And also now we are creating a data frame and converting that data frame into a CSV file, and then pushing that CSV file, like uploading that CSV file into our S3 bucket using upload file. So for that reason, let's create this Yeah, data frame got created with the employee details, employee ID and the name and the department. Now we are converting it to a CSV file with the EMP data. EMP data.csv. So yeah, see here we got created the data. And then this is our CSV file that we got created. Now we are uploading that CSV file into our S3 bucket. So for that reason, here we have to give there are three methods to upload our CSV file. So we are using upload file. There is also upload object, and so put object is also there, but we are using here upload file. So what are the things here? S3.bucket and the bucket name should be mentioned, and also upload file with the file name. So file name is the name of the file, and also EM key is the name of the file that you want to have in your S3 bucket. With this name, the S3 bucket in the S3 bucket the file will be generated. So I'm giving the same both the names for it. So this file I want to place in my S3 bucket. Let's see. Now go to our bucket. See, we have our emp data.csv file. So in this way our file got generated. So our object is also created inside it. Now another what are the to get all the objects present in our objects.all, we will print that objects all. First of all, if we want to upload another file from the console also we can, just by going to our console into our bucket. Here we can click upload. This is through our console we are doing, not through the Python code. So this way also we can add files. So we will press add file, and then we will give some we will just give this input.txt, open it, and we'll just click upload. Yes, our uploaded file, we got the file uploaded. If we go through our bucket, see we have two files. One is a text file and the CSV file. We can also upload JPJ files. All kind of files can be uploaded here. And so now we have uploaded it. Now we will print all what are the objects present in it. So see, we have a emp data.csv file and also input word.txt file. So both the files are there in our bucket. So all the files files are called as objects in S3. And then we are uploading and directly uploading our file from the local system, not by creating or data frame and all. So for that reason, here we have to give the bucket and upload file. Here we are giving the path of the file. So where our input t1.txt file is there, that is the path. And also here we have to give the key name. So key name is nothing but the name of the file which you want to store in your S3 bucket. That name we have to mention it. So both the things I am giving. So now let's check in our bucket. See, I have an input text file. This is also generated. This is also text file. So ultimately we have three files now. And now we are reading the data from our file. So first we are getting the file through dot get. So here giving the bucket name and the object name and get, and also we are reading using data frames. So see, we got our data that is in our emp data.txt, like CSV. What is there? That data is printed here. Next, to read to download the file from S3 to local. So here we all read the data, uploaded the data. Now we are downloading that object from our S3 bucket. So for that reason, what we have to do is a download file key. So this is the name that you want to have. So this is the name that your S3 bucket has, input1.txt. This file I want to download it as a download.csv into my local system, and to read the context present in it using read csv file. So let's run it. See, this is the data that we are getting. So our file also got downloaded. So this is the data present in my input1.txt file. So next, to delete the objects present in my bucket. So all the objects, see bucket, we have to mention the bucket, and we have to fetch objects.all and next delete. So if we run it, see all our objects got deleted with the key. See, we can see input1.txt, emp.csv and the input world.txt. so all those files, if you refresh it in our bucket, you can see no files are present in our bucket now. So afterwards, if we and we want to delete our entire bucket as well. So for our first, initially we will print whether the objects present, nothing, no objects are present in our bucket. And now for to delete our S3 bucket, we use using dot delete, and our bucket will be deleted. See, our bucket got deleted. We can go and check in our see, we don't have any bucket now. So our view bucket list, bucket was not found. So if we go to S3 and we will check it, no bucket is present. So that's why we have using our Boto3 library, we and Python code, we contacted AWS service, that is S3, and we read the files, we read the objects, and we deleted the objects, we downloaded the objects as well. Now we will check what is an S3 versioning. So through console, let's create a bucket and upload the objects into it and perform the bucket versioning. So for that reason, let's create bucket. Bucket name should be unique, so let's create some bucket. Some random bucket, and we have to choose the location. And now after this all, I will be keeping it default. And this block public access settings is that if you click this one, then it is like it will block the public access to your bucket. Only you can visualize it or see it. Right now I am unblocking it, so it I am making it a public and also acknowledging that. And next, this is called bucket versioning. Bucket versioning is that it makes the history of your files. Even if like if you upload the same file with the changes, then it will be stored with a different version IDs. Even if you delete it, the version with the version ID, you can retrieve the data. So we are making the enabling. So after that, that's it. Let's create bucket. See, our bucket got created. And now in your bucket, we are trying to upload the files. Let's upload file, add files. Here, let's give some input1.txt file, open, upload. See, our file got uploaded. And if we give another file also, like we will upload some other files as well. Mm. Okay, input word.txt file, again we will upload it. Upload. See, our upload successful. Now in our bucket, if you see, you have two files. Let upload the same file again. Uploaded the file. Now if you go to S3 bucket, you can see only one file and the input word.txt, but we uploaded the same file again. So to see the versions, here we have to click show versions. If you click the show versions, you can see that same file listing is there. This is called versioning. So with a different version ID, it will get uploaded. That's way. And this way, if you change the data inside it and also upload it, so it will make the history of everything and it will perform the versions. And to clear understanding about version, you can go through AWS documentation of versioning in S3. That's it. Now let's delete the files. So delete. If you see all the three files we are selecting, and we will just copy this so as to delete it. Now delete objects. Three objects has been successfully deleted. So you go to your bucket, you have nothing. If you show versions also, you don't have nothing. And then if you want to delete the, like if you want to, if you don't want to delete it, but you want to delete it after 2-3 days or some 50 days later, automatically if you want to delete it, then you can go to your management and create a life cycle. In that you can give the lifetime period, how much times you want to delete it and all. There are various properties for it and permissions, so this you can learn in depth. And also events, if you want to host any public hosting, everything you can go through it. And that's it guys. So first we have to delete our bucket as well. It's a best practice to delete or what are the services that we have used, otherwise we will get charged for it. So I'm deleting my bucket as well. So this way we deleted bucket as well. That's it. So in this way we performed our task of bucket versioning and as well as to contact S3 using Boto3 and performing the create, read, update, delete options. So that's it guys. Catch you up in our next video. Thank you.